Which support structure is the best for 3D printing? We all know the typical normal and tree supports. But now there's also support for PLA from Bambu Lab, and recently I've seen many people using PETG as support material too. So which one works best? Let's find out. I started by designing a simple part with a large overhang, intentionally orienting it poorly so I would need support. I also printed a version without support, orienting it properly to have a reference with the correct dimensions for comparison. Now I've printed a part using 4 different support methods. With each print I removed the supports and compared the results. Normal and tree supports were quite difficult to remove, while PETG and support for PLA came off very easily. The surface finish of the prints using PETG and support for PLA were perfect, with the part dimensions staying accurate. However, with the normal and tree supports, the surface finish wasn't as smooth and the accuracy was a bit off. Since PETG gave the same results as support for PLA but is much cheaper, I'd recommend using PETG in the future when possible. Sometimes I see questions pop up on forums where users try to print a benchy using support for PLA. But remember, support for PLA is not meant to be used as a full printing material. This is stated clearly on the packaging. If you want a clean benchy print, stick with regular PLA. And just for fun, I attempted to print a benchy using support for PLA, first at normal speed and then with the fastest settings. Support for PLA can't handle overhangs well, and it's very brittle. During the high-speed print, it even broke off while printing the chimney. So, there you have it. Support for PLA isn't designed for full prints, and PETG works great as a support material for saving costs. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.